Hello, this is Eric D. Kirk for mamoworld.com, and welcome to the second part of our tutorial series in which I show you how we created the promo video for the Squash and Stretch cartoon bundle. In the first part, we created this design and focused on the creation of the grainy texture look. Now, with exactly the same approach, I created comps for all main parts of the animation. So we start with this design. Then we want to transition to 37 behaviors, and then 242 sound effects. And after that, time for some fun. And finally, show the title we created in the first part of the tutorial series. Since nothing is animated yet, at this point you can still add or change text or other elements very quickly. Therefore, before animating any of this, you should be sure that this is the content that you really want to have. If you are doing this for a client, you should take a screenshot of all those designs, turn them into a storyboard, and then send the storyboard to the client so that they can already get a pretty good idea of the concept before you put any efforts in more details. So let's assume that our client approved the storyboard and we start animating the scenes. Each scene has one key animation that the viewer should focus on. This is the most intense or interesting animation, and it is typically applied to the biggest or most relevant element in the scene. In this first scene, as key animation, we want to animate the text "Create." For all animations of this project, we use the cartoon bundle of Squash and Stretch Pro. Squash and Stretch is an After Effects extension that we developed here at Mama World, and it comes with a free and pro version. The pro version can be extended with additional bundles, and as you can see, I have installed here the glitch bundle, the broadcast bundle, and the cartoon bundle, for example. Each of these bundles contains a lot of ready-to-use behaviors. Let's choose the elastic drop behavior and then click the work area button here. This sets the duration of the work area to the duration of the behavior, so we know that when it should start at the beginning of the composition, it will end here. So we place the current time indicator where the animation should end, make sure the text layer is selected, choose one of the available sound effect variants, let's choose Boing Bright in this case, and click Apply. Now, Squash and Stretch recommends to split the text into individual letters so that they all animate individually. This usually looks better, so we click OK. As you can see, the letters now animate nicely and even have nice sound effects. There are many different sounds, but they are all inside this layer here, which is actually a pre-comp. If we open the pre-comp, you can access all the individual sounds if you want. The default is actually that Squash and Stretch places all sound effects in the main comp, but to keep everything organized, I change this here in the Squash and Stretch preferences by setting the arrangement option to Precompose SFX Layers. Now we want to change the timing a bit so that the letters do not all appear exactly at the same time. So we move one of them a few frames, and now we want to distribute all other layer start points randomly between the first and this last one. We could do this manually, but a much faster way of distributing the layers is using the stagger layer tool of Squash and Stretch here in the toolbar. So we make sure all letters of create are selected and click on the stagger layers icon. This tool can distribute layers in various ways. We want to distribute them based on the layer endpoints in a random order. The tool distributes the layers between the earliest and the latest layer endpoint, so if you want them to move more, you would need to move the layer a bit more by applying the stagger layers tool. Now the layers drop in the scene in a random order, but the sound effects do not fit anymore. Since each letter has a different timing now, we need to duplicate our sound layer for each letter and move each copy so that it starts exactly where the layer of the corresponding letter starts. Wow, so we created a pretty complex animation with sound effects, and it just took us a few minutes. Sometimes you want Squash and Stretch animations to interact with other elements in the scene. In the title scene here, for example, we want to use the jump in double behavior, and it should first bounce on the line here and then jump into the final position. If we apply the behavior, the result does not look as you might expect. If we zoom out, you can see that the layer bounces outside of the visible range of the composition. So we want this entire movement to be about half as big. To do this, we set the oomph parameter to 50%, undo the last application of Squash and Stretch, and apply it again. Now this is much closer to what we want, but still not accurate. So we reveal the position keyframes and find the keyframes where the layer bounces on the line. Here, the second and third keyframe are exactly the ones where it is on the line, so we select both of them and move the layer as needed. To move the layer, make sure to click on the vertices of the actual motion path and not anywhere else on the layer, since otherwise After Effects will introduce an additional keyframe at that current point in time. This is one of the very powerful aspects of Squash and Stretch, that it generates keyframes and that you are able to customize them as needed very easily. So this example shows that sometimes you need to adjust the keyframes of the animation to your scene, but sometimes it also makes sense to do the opposite and to adjust the scene to fit the animation. In this scene, we want to animate the 37 with the jump in stairs behavior. As usual, we select a sound variant, apply the behavior, and confirm the suggestion to animate each letter individually. Now we want to change our line so that it forms exactly the stairs that the letters are jumping down. I click here to enable the rulers, and if I click and drag on the rulers, I get a guideline. At each bounce of the animation, I place one guide and also place vertical guidelines in between the different bounces. Now I select the shape layer of our line and choose the Add Vertex tool. Then I can easily add vertices to the line and snap them to our guides to create the stairs. For the animation of this scene, we want to use the jump in too low behavior, and we want to apply it only to the first 2 of 242. So we select the text and click on the text exploder icon of Squash and Stretch here. Then we choose to split into characters and apply. Now we have three individual layers, one for each letter, so we can just select the first two, again choose a sound effect, and apply the behavior. This should be the main action taking place in the scene, but it does not seem to be placed perfectly. We want the movement to be bigger to cover a larger portion of the comp. Therefore, we undo the application of Squash and Stretch and increase the oomph to 200%, which will make everything move twice as far. By the way, even if this slider goes only up to 200%, you are still able to enter higher values by dragging the number here. Now we apply the behavior again. The animation is so big now that it goes off screen here. To move everything at once, I select all layers except for the background and click on the Create Parent Null icon here. This creates a null layer and parents all selected layers to it so that I can move all of them at once simply by moving the null. Once we are happy with the placement, we can delete the null again. Now, as the previous scene, I create some guidelines and then create a shape layer for the line. Finally, I copy and paste the layer style with the line in the previous scene. In the Time for Some Fun scene, the key animation should be the full animation of the N using the Throw in Wall behavior. So we split the fun text again into individual letters and apply the behavior to the N. Again, we place a guideline where the N collides with the wall and then use it to update our line accordingly. When the N hits the ground, we want it to be exactly on the line, so we reveal the position keyframes, find the ones where it is located on the ground, and move them as needed. So now we have the key animations for all scenes of our video. In the next part, we will combine all those scenes into one fluid and continuous animation, animate the line, and make sure that it fits to the background music. Again, this is Eric D. Kirk for mamoworld.com, and we'll see you next time.